Over many years, the buildup of excess nutrients in the water, such as phosphorus and nitrates, can create what's known as algal blooms. These nutrients can come from agriculture as well as residential use, fertilizers, and other sources, and can have a toxic or harmful effect on the ecosystem, including manatees. Harmful algal blooms can create thick layers at the water surface or within the water column, blocking sunlight from reaching seagrasses and aquatic vegetation. These plants need sunlight to photosynthesize. Without it, they can die. Manatees are herbivores, and without seagrass or healthy vegetation in their aquatic habitat, they have little to nothing to eat. During the summer, they can travel freely to find adequate forage. In the winter, manatees gather near warm water sites, such as power plants or springs. If there's not enough vegetation surrounding these warm water sites, they have to make the tough decision between swimming out to eat or staying at the warm water site. If they choose to stay in the warm water, they risk starvation. In addition to the blue-green algal blooms that cloud the water and in the process kill seagrasses, red tide algal blooms can kill manatees outright. Although red tide is a naturally occurring phenomenon, excessive nutrients in the water can fuel it and create a super bloom. Manatees can inhale toxins when they come up to breathe air, or ingest toxins when they feed on the seagrasses, which can result in seizures and drowning. What is the solution? First, the sources of excess nutrient pollution should be prevented from entering our waterways in the first place. Next, conservation partners are working to restore seagrasses and aquatic vegetation and to clean up our waterways. There are things you can do to help too. Contact your local officials to let them know how important clean water is for you and for manatees. If you live near the water, skip fertilizing your lawn, or at a minimum, use less fertilizers and don't fertilize before it rains. Algal blooms happen all over the state of Florida and will involve long-term dedication to fix. We can all work together to help speak up for clean water and a healthy aquatic habitat for manatees. Learn more about this issue and how you can help at savethemanatee.org/algae.